right, fans? It's Monday, so it's time to look for the answers to all things in my sack, my mail sack. Each week leading up to an increasingly irrelevant Triple THS on Wednesday, I ask you, my loyal subjects, to humor me with your questions, because I can't take the time or effort to make a second show each week on my own. Then to make you forget about how shitty this whole thing really is, I give one person a Tommy Tuchel t-shirt that I must admit is pretty snazzy looking. Let's do this shit!
Tommy sack!
Mark Bogutski. Did Vitor pull off the first mohawk slash mullet at the same time?
Not even close. He would have had a better chance pulling off the fabled hawk mo, which is when you just shave a stripe down the middle of your head and leave the rest. You can't just take two hair extremes and throw them into the mix together. It's too dangerous. Like engineering dinosaurs and then leaving Newman in charge of literally everything with no single person on the entire fucking island having any clue how shit works. Vitor's body looks like he's 26, but his face looks like he's 56. And 56-year-olds don't rock mohawks with rat tails on the end of them. They either quietly accept their horseshoe pattern baldness or shave their heads and hope to God that their skull isn't shaped funny. All that said, it makes Vitor even funnier than he already is, so keep that goofy shit up.
James Henson. Will I ever get to see you order Taco Bell?
Sure, why the fuck not?
Thank you for choosing Taco Bell. Order whenever you're ready.
Yeah, can I get 3 soft tacos, 12 hard tacos, a burrito supreme, 6 chalupas, a Big Mac if that's possible, a bucket of these cinnamon twist things, a gallon of strawberry fettuccine, 19 cheese quesadillas, a grilled stuffed turkey, 5 rice and beans, 8 taco salads with 3 sides of nacho cheese, and a small diet Mr. Pibb.
Is everything correct on the screen?
I cannot read, but I'm sure it's close enough.
That for here to go.
It's for here. Don't judge me.
You ordered 62 items off the menu, so your total today will be $3.73. Enjoy your meal, sir.
You too. Thank you. Damn it.
Ryan English. Shin pads?
Yes, maybe? I'm not sure I understand the question. Are you asking me if shin pads exist? Are you asking me if I want shin pads? Do I like shin pads? Are shin pads something people should use? Are you questioning a decision I made in regards to shin pads? Will I be voting for shin pads in the next election? What the fuck is going on right now, Ryan? You can't just send me a noun with an upward inflection at the end without any context. I can play that game too. Hey, Ryan, I got a question for you. Pillows? Yeah, not so nice, is it?
Balthazar Shepard. With UFC 160 just around the corner, and Hunt possibly a no-show, how will JBJ ruin this event even further?
I don't know, but I'm sure he'll find a way, and I'm sure it'll somehow involve pictures of lions, really awkward dancing, and some portion of his body saying fuck being a part of this, and trying to rip itself away to start a new life in Thailand.
The legendary Sean Shahan. If you had to pick 4 MMA fighters to be in a remake of Cool Runnings, who would they be and why?
Well, I think I speak for everyone when I say, I want John Candy to return in his role as the lovable coach Irving Blitzer, this time in zombie form. The rest of the squad's a piece of cake. Darice takes himself too seriously, so John Jones will be perfect. Sanka was the lovable loser in comic relief, so who better than the entire Black Zillions team? Junior was the preppy guy, so I'm gonna throw a wild card in here and say Rory McDonald. And Yule gave zero fucks, which means he must be played by Nick Diaz. Tell me you wouldn't see that movie and I will call you a liar straight to your lion face. You liar.
Jeremy Guthrie. As a cartoon character, I'm led to believe you have an arch nemesis. What is his name and what does he look like?
That would be Tony Thumbpoke. He was created by Coach Jamie Huey, and once an idea like that is put down on paper or a shirt, it becomes real. He's been standing outside my house ever since. Go away, I'm not coming outside.
Eventually, you're gonna need more toilet paper. I can wait.
Ollie V. Could Jacare choke out a tortoise?
I cannot think of any situation in which Jacare would need to choke out a tortoise. You can damn sure bet that if it ever came down to that, that tortoise is going night-night. They can't hide in their shells forever. The more important question is, can Jacare choke out a dinosaur? A dinosaur who's more jacked than the fucking Ultimate Warrior and is throwing spinning shit with the velocity of an SR-71 Blackbird.
Chris Vargas. I don't think I've ever seen Anderson Silva bleed. What exactly is being circulated through his system?
I have no idea, but we might find out on July 6th, since Chris Wiener turned Mark Munoz's head into the elevator from The Shining. My guess is some type of fully synthetic motor oil, or possibly millions of microscopic Steven Seagals.
Jake Bauman. Are you running out of Warrior promos yet?
I am not, but if I ever do, I think these 3 have got me covered.
You don't know where I'm gonna be, Hogan!
No rules!
Your destruction!
No rules!
Your
Somebody had some extra crazy with their Pop-Tarts that morning. T-shirt time! Each week, one of the people that makes the show is chosen by a computer without feelings to receive a Triple THS t-shirt. Because they're red and they're awesome and they have my face on them. This week's winner comes to us from Richard Greathead, who asked,
Tommy, for all my life, people have made fun of my name. Can you recommend a name that I could change to that would not only stop them from making fun, but also install fear into their hearts?
First of all, Dick, you should never be ashamed of your name or of anything else that was out of your control. Sometimes you're born with legs that are foot long and arms down to the ground. But you gotta roll with it. Make the best of what you're given and wear that Greathead crest proudly, Dick. But if you're helping on changing your name to something cooler, I do have some suggestions. Axe Killersby, Dagger Jagger, Gunner Fox, Justice Deathplow, King Dick, Rocket Wolf Puncher, and if you're into being dark and mysterious, Draven. Just Draven. Go forth and be awesome, Dick. That's Show Fight fans. If you want the awesome ass t-shirt that's headed Richard's way, go to tripleths.com right now and buy one because horse meat ain't cheap, damn it. If I didn't answer your question, try asking it to Dear Abby and see if she can solve your problem. New episode of Triple THS Wednesday with Dinosaurs and Diaz is oh my.